our presenters, all our volunteers, our sponsors, our steering committee, and our board of directors, because without everybody, we couldn't be here. And in 3 short years, I think we have grown amazingly because you guys have all had the confidence to join the organization and travel with us on this journey. So round of applause for everybody. Thank you to everybody. And a little extra special thank you to the team of people that have worked with me since last September to make this summit happen. And I'm not going to name them all because there's too many of them, but you know who you are, so thank you. And you have 2 weeks off, and then we're going to start planning the summit for next year, all right? And I have shared my Wednesday evenings with this group of people at 8:30 for the last 13 months. So they've got 2 Wednesdays free, and then we're back on track for more stuff. So enjoy the next 2 Wednesdays. All right, so where are we going? Okay, we've come a long way. We started, PPG became an idea in December 2011 and then became a reality in 2012. It has not always been easy. It has on some occasions been a little bit rocky, but you know what? It's been a hell of a lot of good fun, so thank you to all of you for that. The first 50 people, and if your name's on here, clap to you. These are the first 50 charter members that jumped on board without any questions. Within the first month, the application started coming in. So you'll always be our charter members, so thank you. And I'm seeing a few. We've got Cindy down here and Angelica. And who else in here is one of our charter members? Nancy over there. God, I know so many of you. It's amazing. Facebook's an incredible marketing tool, isn't it? I feel like you know all these people, and in fact, you don't. And obviously, our special counsel, and I am going to name them individually. Dr. Karen Overall, who has been on board since day one, and thank you. Angelica suggested to me that we obviously needed to appoint or ask some special people to join us, to support us. And the first name that came to mind was Dr. Karen. And I emailed her and asked for a telephone meeting with her. I'd never spoken to her before. And I think she grilled me for about an hour. And then at the end of the call, she said, okay, I'm in. And she's been in ever since. So Dr. Karen Overall, Jean Donaldson, James O'Hara, Joan Orr, Jennifer Shryock, Victoria Stilwell, who so wanted to be here and actually had planned to be here, but her filming schedule changed, so couldn't be here. Dr. Lynn Honickman, Dr. Jean Dawes, Dr. Robert King, and Helen Phillips are all our special counsel of the sort of North America PPG, because as you all know now, we have these new chapters that have all opened. So since then, we have rolled out more than 30 membership benefits. We've opened PPG chapters in Australia, the British Isles, and Singapore, and we have more coming online next year. And I'm just going to refer to my notes here because I do not want to miss out on some of the things that we've done. This year in particular, we rolled out the PPG archives. Do you guys all know what the PPG archives are? Do you read your emails? Yeah. Okay, PPG Archives is a brainchild of Susan Nilsson, who's our editor for Barks from the Guild. And it's on our website, and it's basically a collection of every single blog, article, letter, president message, and it's all searchable. It's a fantastic resource, a lot of scientific articles on there. So if you're looking for articles to use for client communication or just to help you in your business, go to the PPG Archives and search. So you can search by author name, you can search by topic, and it will just throw back at you some amazing resources. So PPG Archives. So thanks to Susan for that. We rolled out some great force-free marketing collateral, which there was one of those in your swag bag. So I hope you all saw the quality of that. PPG World Services, which we did have initially and then it stopped. So Louise Stapleton Propel. I always pronounce her name incorrectly. I got it right. Yeah. That was what I've been most anxious about for the last 2 weeks, pronouncing your name right. We have rolled out a cat committee. So any of you guys that work with cats, we now have a great cat committee. You may not know, but we also have a PPG advocacy committee. Did you guys know we have an advocacy committee? And I think there's 12 people working on that, and they're working on a really exciting program that's going to roll out next year, which I can't talk about because I'll be in big trouble. We rolled out the Pet Professional Accreditation Board, which is an independent certification for dog trainers and behavior professionals that are clearly saying no to shock, choke, and prong. So that was a great initiative. Woohoo! And, I mean, so much more to do, and in just a few minutes, I'm going to talk about some of the things that are coming up. I wanted just to share with you my personal humble opinion on a couple of things. I strongly believe that what we do is a tripod of science, art, and relationships, and that those three things all sort of underpin each other. And everything we do has to be underpinned in science. It has to be executed with artistic creativity. And Emily Lalam's here, and isn't she the most creative person that anybody can watch? Everyone just loves Emily. And then it's about relationships. It's about everything that we do has to be mutually beneficial to the pet, the pet's owner, and to us. And we have a serious responsibility and obligation to advocate on behalf of the pets and the pet owners and us and our philosophy and everything we do. So, you know, we have a huge responsibility on our shoulders because everything that we do directly impacts the welfare of animals on a daily basis. And I think we all know that, which is why we take our role so seriously. All right, I think this is important. I think often we feel that we have to convince everybody that our way is the right way, and actually all we have to do is convince them just to try, because more often than not, we know when our clients do try, what happens? We get great results, don't we? And through what we do, and through our demonstrations, and through working with our clients, force-free training can stand up and be counted. The results are there, we know the results are there, the clients see the results, and it makes it a lot easier for us. So let the results of what we do stand up. It makes it a lot easier for us. What sets PPG apart? Well, from day one, our guiding principles. The guiding principles were written before PPG even started. Because when we wrote the guiding principles, we wanted to be sure that can we have an organization that has guiding principles, and can these guiding principles actually be adhered to? And I think in many ways we did a really good job, because we've sort of divided them into non-negotiables, which are no shock, prong, choke, pain, or fear. And then we have the other areas of our guiding principles, which basically says that as professionals, you have autonomy to use the systems and the protocols that you want, but work within the guiding principles of those non-negotiables. We have a great ethics committee that does handle ethics complaints. It's all done very confidentially. So if someone does sort of squeeze through the system, we have a way to be able to manage that afterwards. So guiding principles are really, really important. And I'm challenging all of us as ambassadors of our organization to continually learn, because, you know, force-free training is not always the easy way, is it? I mean, the easy way is to shock a dog or punish a dog. So we have to be ambassadors for what we're doing, which means we have to continually educate ourselves and be the best at what we can be so that we get the results. And then the results can stand up for themselves. So I'm challenging all of you. Obviously, you meet the challenge because you've all chosen to come to the summit. So learn from each other, learn from your colleagues, help mentor the sort of industry newbies that come into our industry, and be open to, there's three words that I've used from day one, and if you go back to our website and look at our initial charter, the three words are engage, educate, and empower. They are there in the first document that was ever written. Why? Because if we don't engage people, we cannot educate them. So we have to be open to engaging, educating, and then hopefully empowering people to make the right decisions, to use the right methods. And if we don't have that dialogue, we can't influence anybody that comes into our world. So engage, educate, and empower. Where are we going? Okay, so my next slide, meeting the challenge. From day one, I think we've always made it very clear that when this is not a sprint, it's a marathon. And we're not gonna create massive waves in our industry. It's gonna be ripples that eventually become bigger and bigger. And so, you know, when I talk to our steering committee or the board of directors, we're always talking about, look, as long as we're going in the right direction and we see the effects and the impacts of what we're doing, then I'm okay with that. And it suddenly occurred to me that, like, how many of you run marathons? I know there's a couple of marathon runners in here because I see you post on Facebook, yeah. And we all, I mean, I've done marathons, and we all know when we do marathons that there are sections of the marathon where you are so in the zone that you just, in bliss. And there are other sections where you see a 2-mile hill and it's like, oh my God, how am I gonna get up there? And then you're desperate for water and you can't find a water station. So I think about our PPG journey as being like a marathon. There's some times that we're just in the zone and we're all just humming along and it's all great. And then we all hit those rocky times where we get burnout and we don't seem to be getting our message across. So think about it like a marathon. There will be a finish line. We'll get across the finish line. Some of us will be a bit more haggard when they get there than others, but we will certainly get across the finish line. So think about it in terms of the long term and not the short term. And I actually wrote a note here for myself that when we get those days when we feel really bad, just hitch up your britches, get out of bed, and just start a new day. Because we all know a new day, new accomplishments. And that way that we can really positively impact pets' lives. All right, I only have a couple more slides. Okay. Isn't this a wonderful graphic? Yeah. We've got to collaborate without boundaries. So PPG was never designed to be a sort of an inclusive organization. It was always designed to be open and to engage and educate and empower others. And that's why we have our provisional membership. So that anyone that philosophically buys into our methods and systems but doesn't necessarily have the tools can come into the organization without any judgment or fear of being ostracized and can benefit from this great network of professionals to help them along their journey. So we've got to identify barriers, we've got to eliminate barriers, and we've got to engage and engage and engage people. And I'm going to refer to Pat here because when we first started PPG, you also called me, and Pat wanted to know, you know, what was PPG going to be like? Because it was important for you that we were professional and that we were educational and we did engage. And I don't think there's anyone in here that truly wants to be in an organization that ostracizes others, especially as I think Dr. Susan Friedman always says, they're doing what they know. And if we can teach them and they know more, they will do better. So I think that's one of our really important goals is to make sure that we educate people. Oh. Promote what you love. Promote what you love and what you inspire rather than bash and draw attention to that which you hate. So, I mean, how many of us fall into the trap sometimes of... And I see it on Facebook where we see a post we don't like or a piece of equipment and everybody suddenly gravitates into that direction and everybody's talking about it. And I'm just thinking, you're giving these people free marketing. You're marketing the business for them. So rather than do that, why not put your own post up there or post an article or an educational message and, you know, talk about what inspires you and what you really enjoy. And let's promote that so that people out there that are looking to select a trainer or a behavior expert are being flooded with the great, positive, inspirational message and not the bashing and the hatred and the bigotry that can go along with some of the other stuff. So again, promote what you love and what you inspire to teach rather than bash what you hate. Oh, 2015, wow, it's been so busy. And I was telling all these guys yesterday that after this, I'm taking a month off. But we've got some great goals for 2016, and I wanted just to take a couple of minutes and share those with you so that you know where we're going and what we're working on. And I will refer to notes here. Excuse me. We have a lot of committees in PPG. There are probably about 60 or 70 volunteers working all over. We have a team of people working on a fantastic companion dog assessment program in Australia. Where are you guys? Because I know there's three or four of you over here. Yeah, these guys have worked so hard over the last 6 or 7 months to develop this amazing program, and headed up by Deborah Milliken, one of our board members. So we're going to be rolling that out next year. So that's a great, you know, great group of people in Australia down under that are working so hard. So just to sort of, I'm going to give you some bullet points here, and I'll make this as quick as I can. We have a member services committee that next year is going to work on the companion dog assessment program, a force-free pet care technician certification program, more membership benefits, and we're going to roll out some really nice membership recognition programs. We are, Don Hansen, who's not able to be here today, but Don had suggested that we develop a business membership, so those of you that have multiple employees can do that and make it a lot more affordable, so we're going to roll that out next year as well. We're going to put a lot more focus on our feline, our cat committee. And one of the things that I would like to roll out next year is some kind of training hotline for pet owners so that we can do a better job of marketing you and your services in your local areas, and they'll have sort of an 800 number, a vanity number. Then somebody can help them immediately, and then we can make sure that we get them to the right person. The PPG Educational Committee, we're looking at developing a provisional member mentoring program. So we have something in place right now, but it really isn't very formal. So we want to make it a lot more formalized so that our provisional members get the support that they need to be able to move into full membership. We are, of course, going to be working on our 2016 Educational Summit and our 2017 Summit. And we're going to try and do a better job with developing workshops. We're going to be tapping into a lot more third-party resources for workshops and webinars, and rather than just short webinars, sort of longer programs online that are really, really affordable. And then the most exciting program for me, and I've got in typed in big black letters here, secret, because if I hadn't have done that, I would have started talking about our advocacy program, and Daniel Antelec, who's our committee chair, would have had a heart attack. So we're going to roll out a really exciting program next year, which you can all choose or choose not to participate in, which will help you advocate for pets and pet owners in your own local areas. What else? Barks and the Guild. How many of you read and enjoy Barks and the Guild? Woohoo, yeah. And you know, it's such a good quality publication, and we've had a really big challenge in making it super affordable. So I think now if you live in Australia, it costs you, where's Deb, sort of probably $25, which is a lot of money. Even though it's a superior magazine, it's still a lot of money. Worth every cent. So we're going to look at developing a really nice platform where it can be printed on demand wherever you are through local printers. So that's going to be one of our first goals after this summit. The Ethics Committee works really hard. You may not know that, but they do. We do get ethics complaints. They are dealt with very, very confidentially. Catherine Zahner, is Catherine here? Catherine Zahner heads up. Kat's over there in the corner. So Kat heads up our Ethics Committee, and they're really busy. I mean, obviously you don't hear about it because everything is handled super, super confidentially. So next year, the Ethics Committee, the goal is that they're going to join the sort of education foray as well, so that we'll do some good ethics articles in Barks and maybe do some webinars that we can look at things like informed consent and client confidentiality and how to appropriately use social media and marketing. Because I cringe sometimes when I see some of the posts on Facebook and people are like the client name and the client dog, and it's like, oh my God. You know, as professionals, we have an obligation to keep all that information confidential. We shouldn't be out there posting all that stuff unless a client has specifically said, yes, you can post all that information. And if we want to be taken seriously as a profession and dealt with professionally by the veterinarian community, then we need to get on board with adhering to those same types of professional standards. So I think that's pretty much all we're doing next year. My final sentence before I introduce our keynote speaker is, if you want to help change our industry, and in particular if you want to help change PPG, you're going to be more influential by doing it from the inside rather than the outside. So jump on a committee if you've got ideas. We are very member-centric. It's very important to me, and it always has been, that it's your organization. And if you guys want to see things, we are going to do our best to make sure that we implement those. So if you have ideas about things we can do better, things that you would like us to do, and I can name several people in here. I'm looking at one over there, Catherine Braden, who constantly is on the phone with me talking about, why don't you do this, why don't you do that? That's the kind of input we need from you. We need to know what you need to be able to run your business successfully. So in closing, before I introduce Dr. Karen, I've written here, oh, did that just change? Oh, I forgot to change my slides. Lead, follow, or support, your choice, but stay on board and keep challenging us to help you meet the challenges in your business, okay? So on the website, in several locations, there is a form that you can fill out if you want to volunteer. So it is now my great pleasure. I'm going to clap. So I'm going to introduce Dr. Karen Overall, who is no stranger to any of us. Strong advocate for humane techniques and has been a much appreciated and valued partner of PPG right from the very beginning. Dogwise is here, one of our vendors. I recommend that everybody buys Dr. Karen's clinical manual. It has fantastic information in there for dog trainers. It's got great handouts. It's on my desk. It's ragged. Dogwise has them. It is a fantastic investment. So really, go and have a look at it. Just look at the table of contents, guys. You're going to want to buy it. And it pretty much talks to who Dr. Karen is. So without any further ado, Dr. Karen Overall.